This is the second part of certificate creation. We are moving on to the Google Slides. You can just type in Google Slides. Okay, here also, just like the Google form we selected, we can go to a blank form. This is similar to the Microsoft PowerPoint, but then there are not so many options are not available over here, but this is the only option for us to attach easily a certificate to our Google form. So we have to take this. It is better to do this way. You can also do it in the Microsoft and then upload it in the Google Slide and then attach to feedback form, but that is a big process, so I thought this is easier. Okay, now we have a plain template, or you can select a theme from any of these given on your right side. Now I'm going for a plain one, and I'll show you how to create some interesting features over here. Now for that, you can go to the fourth icon over here, fourth option over here, insert. Then under insert, you have so many options. As you can see, go to the shape, and I am selecting this frame from the shapes. On adding that, you will get a broad frame like this. If you get hold on this yellow dot, as you can see here, and pull on it, you can get a thinner frame. You can adjust the width of this frame. Okay, so I am going for a thin frame, and I can also change the color of that frame. Okay, so I have made it blue. Yes, now this is looking quite plain. I would like to add some color over here, but then the problem is, when we are uploading the scanned copy of the signatures, its background will be white, and therefore if it is on a color background like this, it will look awkward. That is why we have to go for a plain white background. Now I can just add some designs, that's all. Now again I am going to the shape, and I am going for a triangle, something like that. Okay, I am adding a triangular shape over here. Again I am inserting another shape, same shape but over here. I can change the, if I pull over here, I can change the direction. Okay, adjust it according to the other one. Yeah, that's fine. Yes, now both are in the almost same shape. If you want to take that under the frame, then give order sent to back, so it has gone below the frame. Here also we can do the same, sent to back. Okay, so that looks fine. Now I want to do some formatting on this. It looks very plain. What I can do is go to, click this three dot. You will get so many options, as you can see over here. You can even type in Malayalam. Go to the format options, drop shadow, that's the option I am selecting, and instead of black I am giving a light blue, so that a shadow occurs over there. See, you can see a small shadow that has come up here. Okay, adjust the transparency. Yeah, that's fine. Again for this also I am doing the same. Okay, now we will see how to add the text. Here you can see in the second line text box is given. Click on that, click on the slide, it appears over there. You can give the name of the college. Okay, now that doesn't look very big or attractive. You can change, select the entire thing, change the font from here. you can go for an Algerian. Okay, we can change, increase the size also, and from here we can make it broad. If you want to change the color of the text, that also can be done. Everything will look blue. No need. We'll do something like this. Okay, that's fine with me. Now again, to enter the content, again I'm going to click the text box, click here. This is to certify that, we have to enter the name of the person, mostly his designation and the college name. That is what we have entered in the Google form. So that also should come on the certificate also. For that, what we have to do is enter two curly bracket and then write full name. Close the bracket again using two curly brackets. Put a comma, space, again open the brackets and write other identifier. Close the brackets, comma, space, again open, other identifier 2. Close the brackets. So these are the things that I require to be entered in the certificate. So we have the full name, other identifier and other identifier 2, which will appear in the Google form questions in the same order. So the rest we have to type. Has participated in the webinar on XYZ webinar, we can write for the time being, held on whatever date, like 2020, organized by the Department of College name, now again you can select the whole thing, insert a favorite font of yours and increase the size also because this is too small. Okay, now to adjust the lining or spacing and all, there are so many options over here. Either you can centralize the whole thing, or you can align to the left, or you may justify it. Anything can be done. Even the spacing between the lines also can be increased or decreased. So these are the various things you can do on the Google slide. Now again we also have to enter the name of the people behind, so you can enter convener and leave the space for inserting their signature also, which can be scanned and enter and added as a picture on your system and easily be copied and pasted over here. Again, one more box I will add here. That will be okay. So their signatures are also required. You can do the alignment. You can see the red line that shows the alignment, so you can adjust however you want based on that line that is given. Okay, so these are the necessary requirements that is required for inserting in the slide. Now if you want to, you can also copy and paste the logo of the college over here or anywhere, wherever you please. Anything can be added here. Okay, so these are the different options that is possible. There are so many options here, shapes and lines all can be selected, which can be added over here in any as per your sense. So this is the basic requirement for creating a Google slide. Now I am leaving it like this. It is auto saved. You don't have to save each time. And to see how it looks in a big manner, you can go to that present and click on that. You will see the whole thing. Then if you want to make any adjustments, I feel that the college name is slightly higher, so I can just bring it down. Okay, again, you can, if you want to see, go to the present and you can see it. Yeah, that's fine for me now. And then just leave it. I'm going back to the feedback form. We had already added certify I'm here. I'm going to click the show certify I'm controls. Okay, it has appeared over here. Now under template, I don't want the default template because we have created a custom one. I click on the use a custom template. Okay, here a new window has appeared. From here, select a new file. Whatever we have done on the Google slide will appear here. See, the first one is what we did now, untitled. I didn't give it a name. You can, if you want, you can give a name over here, like webinar or something. Okay, so according to that, here it will be refreshed. And then click select, then save changes. Yes, so our certificate has been attached to the Google form now, and just you need to click send. If there are only few participants, we can email them individually, or else you can click here and create a link. Click on shorten URL. This is a short link. You can copy that and then attach it to your email and send to the participants. When they fill the feedback form, the certificate will be received after a short while. Hi, this is to show you a sample of the certificate that I received, which I filled and sent to my mail itself. And this is the certificate that has come to my mail. So see, so this is the full name where I entered my name and I entered my designation and the name of the college. So all that has come on the certificate. So this is how the certificate will look to the participant, and you can make all adjustments or add any beautification to this depending on your aesthetic sense. So thank you for listening to this presentation. This is how you create a certificate using CertifyM and Google Form.